Welcome everyone, it's Sherry Carroll for SimonsSstamp.com and I have a color coordinates for you today where I'm creating colored tissue paper. I am calling this one Spring Rain because it reminds me of nice fresh rain and tropical. I've chosen five colors. They are High Dive, Spring Rain, Velvet Orchid, Green Apple, and Fog as my neutral. So I got this crazy idea and I wanted to see if I could color white tissue paper so that I would have my own custom colored tissue paper, and it worked. I've done these four strips, and I have another one. I'll show you how this is done. So I've cut these a little bit broader than about an inch, and I've just cut strips, and I've cut them all at once. So I'm just going to rub this ink pad just right over that tissue paper. I'm okay with it looking irregular and having streaks in it because I'll be cutting this up and using smaller pieces. So once I have that all wet, what I want to do is use my heat tool and make sure I dry it completely. It'll have a sheen to it and you'll need to flip it over and dry the back side, but make sure these are super dry before you go to put them down on your card. Once I have everything dried, I'll cut these in half. Since I'm putting them onto a card front panel, I want little strips. And you can do these all in different sizes if you want. Either way, it will make it look like a mosaic tile or mosaic strips once you're done. I'll be adding these to a panel of Nina White cardstock, and I'm using the 110 weight. And I'm also using my soft matte gel. I'm putting a little bit of gel onto the cardstock, and then I'm laying my tissue paper on top. I am mixing and matching my colors together and just allowing them to overlap slightly. And I am using also that fog just in between as a nice neutral, just in between colors. So I'm just starting to build this up. You can work from bottom to top or work from the middle and go out and just fill up that panel. And this will be an entire panel that we'll be using for the card front. Once I have all my pieces done and I can peel that off my work surface, I'll trim off the excess that is hanging off the back side, and then I'll be able to trim it down to whatever size I want it. Here is a close-up of how this looks. I did add a little bit of white in between just to mute some of those colors out and give me a variation of colors. I was so thrilled that this worked. The next thing I've done is I have die cut white cardstock using the Cosmo Flower Frame Die from Simon Says Stamp. And this gives me a really fine detailed flower, and I've trimmed it down to give myself an outer frame. I have trimmed down my tissue paper panel and I am cutting out a little circle. This will sit behind the flower center so that I can use a piece of foam tape later to lift that up off of the background and it'll hide my foam tape. To adhere my circle in place, I'm adding a few drops of the Simon Says Stamp glue and then I can place my little circle right into that center. I'll be lifting the entire Cosmo flower frame panel up off of the tissue paper background. So I've cut some of my foam tape in half and now I'm adding strips all around the outside of that frame. To add a message to my card, I have added a piece of the purple tissue paper to a piece of white cardstock and I've stamped and embossed my greeting. I've put everything together and I was able to use a piece of Audrey Blue cardstock which matched my color combination really nicely. And I really love how this tissue paper turned out. I can't wait to try it with another combination of colors. I hope I've given you some inspiration for this set of color coordinates colors from Simon Says Stamp. And as always, thanks so much for watching.